praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will tell of your name to my kin. Alleluia. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Those who conducted Paul brought him as far as Athens, and receiving a command for Silas and Timothy to come to him as soon as possible, they departed. So Paul, standing in the middle of the Areopagus, said, "Men of Athens, I perceive that in every way you are very religious, for as I passed along and observed the object of your worship, I found also an altar with this inscription, to an unknown God. What therefore you worship as unknown, this I proclaim to you, the God who made the world and everything in it, being Lord of heaven and earth, does not live in shrines made by man, nor is he served by human hands as though he needed anything, since he himself gives all men life and breath and everything. And he made from one every nation of men to live on all the face of the earth, having determined allotted periods and the boundaries of their habitation, that they should seek God, in the hope that they might feel after him and find him. Yet he is not far from each one of us, for in him we live and move and have our being. As even some of your poets have said, for we are indeed his offspring. Being then God's offspring, we ought not to think that the deity is like gold or silver or stone, a representation by the art and imagination of man, the times of ignorance God overlooked, but now he commands all men everywhere to repent, because he has fixed a day on which he will judge the world in righteousness by a man whom he has appointed, and of this he has given assurance to all men, by raising him from the dead. Now when they heard of the resurrection of the dead, some mocked, but others said, "We will hear you again about this." So Paul went out from among them, but some men joined him and believed, among them Dionysius the Areopagite, and a woman named Damaris, and others with them. After this he left Athens and went to Corinth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your glory fills all heaven and earth.
Your glory fills all heaven and earth.
Alleluia, praise the Lord from the heavens, praise him in the heights, praise him all his angels, praise him all his hosts. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he alone is exalted. The splendor of his name reaches beyond heaven and earth.
Your glory fills all heaven and earth.
He exalts the strength of his people. He is the praise of all his saints, of the sons of Israel, of the people to whom he comes close. Alleluia.
Your glory fills all heaven and earth.
Alleluia.
God is the praise of all his saints, we said in that psalm, of the
comes close. But Paul is then saying that this God has revealed himself in Christ to be Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and we have known him. When he mentions this, using their pagan sources, in him we live and move and have our being, he's attempting to put the Christian message in a way that the Greeks will understand. When they realize that what he's talking about is in fact a radical new teaching for them, including the resurrection of the dead, many mock and say, oh, what's he on about now? And others say, no, we will hear you about this again. And it's important to realize that the Epicureans and the Stoics asked to see Paul. They wanted to hear him. Pagan culture, even around us, wants to hear the message of the gospel. And sometimes when its fullness is preached, and the reality of the forgiveness of sin, the communion of saints, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting, when that reality is preached, sometimes people mock. And others will say, I want to hear more about this. It is, of course, the Spirit who gives us the power to preach convincingly about the truth of God who has made himself known to us in his Son. And so we must beg the Holy Spirit in these coming days. Tomorrow we begin that great novena, Ascension until Pentecost, begging the Holy Spirit to help us preach convincingly to the world around us, which is still very much, in many ways, a pagan world, a world struggling, a world that hedges its bets, has various gods, some of them unknown. The message we preach will liberate them. If we understand our culture and our society and try to love it as Christ wishes to love souls, then we must also pray for the Holy Spirit that our preaching may be convincing. But also, it's a moment to ask ourselves, do I know God? How has God made himself known to me? Have I come to know him better? Have I used this time, even of lockdown, in order to get to know him better? For he has made himself known to us through the Paschal mysteries. Has there been some tragedy or some joy? And have I used both of those opportunities to know God better? For the more I know, the more I love him. Let us pray that the Spirit inspires us, gives us the knowledge and understanding we need, and also helps to increase our charity and our fervour, that our preaching to the world may be convincing. sacrifice and yours, being acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice has made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with passable joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim, Sanctum, Sanctum, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenissimum celi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini, hosanna in in a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
and you said, "We are the chosen you from the world, says the Lord, and have appointed you to go out and bear fruit, fruit that will last. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. Holy Michael Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. We are safeguarded against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke and we humble.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy.